Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. So for today's video, we will be discussing the 5 pros and cons of using social media. So without further ado, let's start! Let me give you an idea on what is social media. Social media is a computer-based technology that facilitates the sharing of ideas, thoughts, and information through the building of virtual networks and communities. By design, social media is internet-based and gives users quick electronic communication of content. So here are the 5 benefits or pros of using social media. First, it builds relationships. Social media is not just about brands connecting with their customers. In fact, at its root, social media is about connecting people to people. From a professional perspective, you can grow your professional network online tremendously by connecting with colleagues, mentors, role models, and other professionals. If you nurture those relationships, you have a full network to tap when you're looking for opportunities or professional guidance. Number 2, you can share your experience. Social media gives you an opportunity to talk about what you know and what you want to be known for. Sharing your expertise will attract potential professional and personal connections. Learn how to present your professional experience, achievements, and results, and you will get more and more opportunities to connect with like-minded people. If you share content on topics that you know much about, you can begin to build credibility. Number 3, using social media increases your visibility. If you spend time honing in on your expertise, consistently managing your social channels, then you have the potential to greatly increase your visibility and even become a thought leader in your space. Good content gets shared, so if you are consistently posting quality content, the more people who share it, the more people see it. It's not just about pushing content. However, you also need to be engaging with other people's content. Following people and interacting with them on social media will work to build relationships and will help to get your name out there for people to turn to. Number 4. Through social media, you can educate yourself. There is a lot of noise on the internet. Social media allows you to hone in on what you really care about and what you really want to read. You can create lists that create content from your favorite people through leaders in the space or media outlets. You can easily learn about current events and things taking place near you. And number 5, by using social media, you can connect anytime. I know to some of you, this may sound like a disadvantage, but the advantage of being able to communicate and connect with anyone instantly outweighs the potential negative. Social media can help you connect before, during, and after networking events, a conference, or a meeting. People can get to know you prior to meeting you and be better equipped to talk in person. I know social media is a land of new opportunity. There are countless personal and professional benefits of using social media. With a little love and care, we can start to build and shape our personal brands into an epicenter of opportunity. So we are now going the 5 cons of using social media. First, social media is addicting. When you are playing a game or accomplishing a task, you seek to do it as well as you can. Once you succeed, your brain will give you a dose of dopamine and other happiness hormones, making you happy. The same mechanism functions when you post a picture to Instagram or Facebook. Once you see all the notifications for likes and positive comments popping up on your screen, you will subconsciously register it as a reward. But that's not all. Social media is full of mood-modifying experiences. Number 2, it increased usage. The more time spent on social media can lead to cyberbullying, social anxiety, depression, and exposure to content that is not age appropriate. Number 3, self-image issues. Social media sites provide tools that allow people to earn others' approval for their appearance and the possibility to compare themselves to others. It can be associated with body image concerns. The selfieholics and the people who most of the time posting and scrolling are the ones most vulnerable to this. In fact, most of college students who use Facebook at least 5 times a day are likely to link their self-worth to their looks. That doesn't mean the main problem is a social media. It only provides a medium for it. Number 4. Fear of missing out. Fear of missing out has become a common theme and often leads to a continual checking of social media sites. The idea that you might miss out on something if you're not online can affect your mental health. And last but not the least, the online versus reality. Social media itself is not the problem. It is the way people use it in place of actual communication and in-person socializing. Friends on social media may not actually be friends and may even be strangers. So guys, this will be the end of our video. I hope you learned something from me. Thank you for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe.